You know, some people can't hear me clearly when I have a mask on. But praise God, he is alive. Amen. You know, God wants us in 2022 to learn a new song. And we were just singing that I want to sing about the goodness of God. We so easily forget how blessed we are. Did you know that you are the most blessed people on earth if you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ? Because this earth is not your home. Hallelujah. You've got a better home. You have a better father. Amen. And you are a new creation. That's who you are in Christ. Amen. And you are under a new covenant. I was so blessed with your testimony, Sydney, because we've forgotten the blessings that we have. You know, everybody wants to be seen as rich, as whatever else you think, driving the best car, having the best house, and whatever else. But inside, those dear people, they look like shriveled up potatoes. They have no heart anymore. There's no conscience anymore. There's no real joy anymore. It has to be helped with drugs and wine and with sex. But we have the true joy in Jesus Christ to have an eternal life, to have an eternal friend, and to have the family of God sitting around us. Hallelujah. That's who you are. And that's the new song that only those can sing that know that they are a new creation in Christ Jesus. When you worship God during this worship time and you feel uncomfortable, that's because you're not close enough to God. He wants to draw you closer. He's not pushing you away. And this theme this morning for our message is fully devoted together. That's when you see somebody really in love with somebody else, then I appreciate my wife more. Did you know that? I'm more devoted to my wife because I see devotion in that couple. How they hold hands, how they look at each other, how they call each other by different sweet names. Amen. That's being devoted. And so God wants a church that's fully devoted together unto him. And that's our goal for 2022. And I was amazed. You know, we're so blessed with one another. There's nothing that God favors more. You know, the preacher that brings the word here is not more favored than you who listen, because it's about the word of God. It's about Jesus. It's about the center, and that is Christ Jesus. I just need to look at my watch, otherwise I carry away here. The last service, Sydney, on Sunday, on the 2021, that was our Christmas day. Tish brought an amazing message, and he spoke about the oneness of the church. God is one, and everything that is in God is one. Hallelujah. We are one in Christ. Amen. And you know, it's interesting that in the book of Revelation, Jesus never says, you know, the Spirit is speaking to who? He who has ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit says to who? To what? The church. God is not speaking to the world. Is that a shocking statement? I'm not condemning the world. The world condemns itself because they've turned away from the Lord. But the exciting thing is that Tish reminded us of the power of this togetherness, that oneness that God has for us. You know, in Psalm 133, there is something written about the church. Isn't it amazing? You know, when you get to know your Bible a bit better, then you realize how wonderful the Bible is and how it tells you and reveals things to you that you never thought are actually in the Bible. So here we are, Psalm 132. And this relates in my understanding to the Church of Jesus Christ, because we need to ask God to change our minds. Amen. Because we are individually programmed. It's all about me, myself, and my mother's son. And perhaps you, the daughter. But the point here is that the church is God's purpose to bring us together. And when he sees that togetherness, there's a twofold togetherness. There is a togetherness in the flesh. Yes. You know, you were so in love with this guy, and now you feel so heartbroken because you were so happy. But your happiness did not come from the peace of God. You were led by your own desire. And that joy will not last very long. But when you are led by the Spirit of God, you have a joy that the world has not given to you, and the world can't take it from you. You can rejoice in every situation by Christ Jesus. And guess what? You even can say hallelujah or amen in this church. Amen. I'm not preaching to the frozen chosen. Praise God. So let's just see what happened. What God did when he gave birth to the church. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. That's God's will. His fire on each and every one of us. There's no distinction. You are not better. You, because of your title or because of your gift or because of whatever else you want to use to separate. God says, we are one. And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues. Hallelujah. Now that is a very emotional and exciting statement that happened on the birthday of the church. The birthday of the church. Are you with me? It's your birthday. Hallelujah. There are not many people these days that celebrate Pentecost. Now, but in the same chapter, it revealed something even more exciting. And that it is written in verse 42 to 47. Because it showed us what the church was busy with. What actually made up the church. What is at the foundation of the church. They devoted themselves. Our theme here is fully devoted together. And that's what happened in Acts chapter 2 verse 42. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to prayer. There were four things that they were doing. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. We can look out for a few more signs and wonders. Amen. All the believers were together. All the believers were together. You see, we have so many splinter churches and splinter this and splinter that. And you think, is God confused? God is not confused. You know why? Because the unity of the church was never created by man. The unity of the church has been created by the Holy Spirit through Jesus Christ, because we are all in Christ. The only thing that you and I can do about the unity of the church is humble ourselves, bear with each other, and acknowledge that our hearts need to be broken. Because if we allow the spirit of the world to come into the church, and these days you no longer see a difference between the world and the church, there's no longer a holy church, everything goes. And so we, as the ones who are called to live a holy life and be together, we are missing out. We're learning from the world is not learning from us. 2022, people need to be able to look at you and wonder, what's different about that person? So here it says in the next few verses that what they were doing. What were they doing? First of all, they were devoting themselves to the apostles' teaching about Jesus. They only taught about Jesus. Hallelujah. And they used the Old Testament. Then what else did they do? They came together to fellowship. You know, a very old saying about fellowship, I remember it from years ago. You know, fellowship, true fellowship is two fellas in one boat. That's fellowship. You're together in this. It's togetherness. You know, we want to run away from one another and we isolate from one another and we think we're getting better. But together. Bank Windhoek has got one good slogan. Together we can do better. Okay. But it's not about Bank Windhoek, amen? It's a heavenly bank. We want to have a heavenly bank, amen? So, and then they broke bread, hallelujah. And then they committed themselves. They devoted themselves to what? To prayer. That's right. So Christ is the head of the church. And we together are the body. Do you sometimes... What Sidney said is actually exactly what he experienced. He experienced that he is now part of the body. And he is so comfortable because Christ is the head. We at home, in that sense, not fully. You see, we still are being saved. Are you with me? You're not perfect yet. You're not it yet. I don't want anybody to think in 2022 that we've arrived. No. We haven't arrived and we will not arrive unless Jesus comes. Hallelujah. That's always a possibility. Don't put that out of your mind. So, Jesus is the head of the church. Jesus is not a philosopher. Hallelujah. Who is looking for truth. He is the truth. Hallelujah. Jesus is not a mystic who acted strangely and everything was strange and people were wondering, what's he doing? No, Jesus is reality. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. Hallelujah. Was Jesus a reformer? Some people say he was. No, Jesus is not a reformer. Jesus is the creator. You are the new creation. Hallelujah. And you can sing a new song. Amen. Now, was Jesus a visionary? I mean, there's so much talk about visionaries and dreaming and all this stuff. And you think, you know, they're so spiritual, these people. And was he a visionary? Ask yourself. Was he? We just celebrated who he really is. He is the light of the world. That's who Jesus is. Hallelujah. He doesn't need you and me to have a vision. He wants to be the light, my light here in me that brings life to me and understanding. Praise God. Isn't that exciting? So, in brief then, we need to understand that God is not a task-orientated ruler. God loves people. He designed the church. He designed the church as a means for people to love him and one another. That's the design that God had for his church. Glory be to God. So when we were worshiping here, we are learning together, helping each other to love the Lord, express our devotions to him, and then somehow, when we look at one another, we no longer see the negative stuff. The love of God gives us new glasses. And you know, the exciting thing, three-dimensional glasses, you know, we saw a film with the kids in Swakop, and it becomes so real, it's, you know. So that's when we love Jesus, we all of a sudden, the love for one another becomes so much more real. It jumps, it's no longer just on a screen, on paper. It's become reality inside here. It's bubbling up. Amen. So we are now devoted to the apostles' teaching. And by the way, Ray Oliver is coming shortly this month from the 28th to the 30th to bring some apostolic input. We are also part of the New Covenant Ministry International. That's where we acknowledge the apostolic teaching. And then the fellowship, obviously, the exciting part is that apart from our gathering on a Sunday, we also have what? What do we have? Life groups. And they start again in February. First week of February. Life groups are starting. Let's get ready. Because that's where we have fellowship. That's where you can hear what the person is going through during the week. And that's where you can have some fellowship with him and pray with him and make friends. Hallelujah. And in Hebrews it says we should do that all the more as we see the day approaching. Which day are we seeing approaching? When you looked yesterday, did you see the rain approaching? It was. I didn't see it, but it was approaching. But later on in the afternoon, it actually happened. Isn't that exciting? So the day is approaching, whether you like it or not. But you know, the Bible never told us that we need to worry about the date. We only need to be focused on Jesus. Hallelujah. Because he comes as a thief in the night. And he says he doesn't want to find us naked when he comes. He wants us to be fully dressed in white robes. Amen. I need to be a bit quick this morning because I've asked Mary, just, you know, the last part in this service is the breaking of bread. There's been a lot of teaching about prayer. Prayer is actually when you have a burden about something. I have a burden. When Esther and I, we go for a walk, I have a burden to pray for Namibia, to pray for the weather, to pray for the economic recovery, to pray for jobs that will be created. That's a burden. It's not something that I sort of think about and think, yeah, that's a very good idea. No, it's a burden. And what's so exciting is Ed, in his last message on the 2nd, he said that when we kneel before God in prayer, then we can stand before men. Amen. Because then God gives us his grace and his understanding that we have not just our own ideas, but we can say, God is leading me to do this, that, or the next thing. And so this year we want to continue with our vision for God touching the nation. It commenced in 2018, and we've done it through these years. But the exciting thing is, God is just wanting us to expand more. He wants his kingdom to expand. He wants the city to be touched. He wants this nation to be touched. and he wants us to go even further. Are you dreaming? I'm dreaming about going to Cuba and preach the gospel there. Yes, I don't know why. It gives me joy when I think about it. Fidel Castro, I think he tried his best. He was a revolutionary and so on. But now his people are unhappy because they're missing out on Jesus. God wants you to get your passport ready. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Yeah, and then on the 18th, 19th and 20th of this month, we have prayer and fasting so that we get in tune with God, what God has for us. It's not something, you know, when you devote yourself to prayer, it's not something that's a quick fix and it comes immediately. But when you are devoted to prayer, there is a process taking place. And this is what happens. It leads you to healing. It leads you into purity. And it leads you into growth when you devote yourself to prayer, where you give, like Ed gave a wonderful outline. You're not just praying, you're not just reading the word, you're not just praying for others, but it's a whole desire from your heart that you want to be just intimately with your Heavenly Father. You shouldn't leave the prayer place without an embrace from Father's heart. That's all I want to say. And so in closing, I want to just say, I hand over now to our brother Mering to just give us that blessing. I want to still read that verse in or that chapter in Psalms 133. I got a bit too excited. There it is. Hello, come on. Have you ever noticed that when you look for it, it's not always easy to find it? How good and how pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity. That's the picture of the church. It is like precious oil poured on the head. Poured on whose head? On the head of the high priest. In the Old Testament, who was the head? It was Aaron. Here it says, running down the beard, running down on Aaron's head, down on the collar of his robe. It is as if the dew of Hermon were falling on Mount Zion. But in the New Testament, our high priest is our Lord Jesus Christ, and his anointing flows over his whole body. Hallelujah. And then it says, for there the Lord bestows his blessing. What's God's blessing? Even life forevermore. Even life forevermore. In the new year, 2022, you are no longer called to sow to your flesh. In 2022, you sow to your spirit. And if you sow to your flesh, you will reap corruption and destruction from your flesh. But in the new year, when you sow to the Spirit, hallelujah, then you will reap what? Everlasting life.
Amen.
The Lord bless you. And remember those four things. The church devoted themselves first of all to what? The apostles' teaching. Right? To fellowship together. Right. To the breaking of bread. Right. And to prayer. And if you do that, you will be fruitful. Thank you. Thank you, my brother.
Good morning, church. It's been such a while since I've been here. I almost feel nervous. But it's awesome to see all of you. Just stand up quickly and take a deep breath. Let's just make sure with that we're present, actually. Okay? All right, let's have a seat. So we've got the fellowship here, and now we want to do the breaking of bread. And it's amazing. Communion is one of those things that's only meant for the believers. It's not meant for the world out there. It's only us, those who follow Jesus, those who have decided to follow him. And just thinking about it, especially this piece in Acts 2 verse 40 onwards, talking about the breaking of bread, and I think how many of those people actually knew Jesus. A lot of them knew him. In the past few years, they had journeyed with him. They had seen him go about doing things, preaching. They had listened to his preachers. But they've also seen him touch people, heal them. And within him, Jesus, within his body, he carried that healing, that health. When he stretched out his hands and he placed it on someone, there was healing. When he mixed his spit with mud, or with dust, and created mud, brought about sight. When he spoke to people, brought about healing. Within him, he carried the blood that needed to be spilt on the cross for us. He carried all of that within him perfectly. He was the perfect lamb. And I just like us this morning to read in Luke 22. They can just put it up. Luke 22 verse 14 says, "And when the hour was come, he sat down and the 12 apostles with him. And he said unto them, with desire I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say unto you, I will not any more eat thereof until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God. And he took the cup and gave thanks and said, take this and divide it amongst yourselves. For I say unto you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God shall come. And he took bread and gave thanks and brake it and gave it unto them, saying, this is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. Likewise, also the cup after supper, saying, this cup is for the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you. So we do this in remembrance of Jesus. And as we place our focus on Jesus for 2022, we want to keep on breaking bread together as a community, as believers, as family, in our houses, as a family in your house. Continue breaking bread together. Do it together. When you have fellowship together, you've invited someone over for dinner, break bread together. Be reminded of what the cross means for us, what happened on the cross, what Jesus did for us, that he paid that ultimate price. So before we pray together, let's just start from one side. If this block can start and just get up, and maybe just fetch a piece of bread and a glass. And once they're done, one section of the middle block can continue, and the same on that side. Sorry? There's also a table right at the back. So those who are seated right at the back, you can just get a piece of bread there and a small cup, and then just take a seat and we can pray together. Okay, let's start here. So you guys can as well. You can just, starting at the front, just the one block first. Just get a piece of bread and a cup. So all of you can get up. It's a... I think while everyone's busy just getting a piece of bread and a cup, for the rest of us, just maybe just close your eyes and just be focused on Jesus. Okay, let's not just have a piece of bread or a cup in our hand, but let's really think about Jesus and what he did for us, his life on earth, the 3 years with the disciples, just how amazing it was. Okay, let's do this as a body together. Let's all stand. And let's just hold up this piece of bread that represents the body of Jesus that needed to be broken for us. Lord Jesus, and we come this morning in remembrance of you, Lord. And we want to thank you, Lord, for how you lay your life down for us. Lord, we think about how your body was broken and beaten, Lord. And that it was for us, Lord. We're reminded of that it says that by your stripes we are healed, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you were broken so that we can be made whole, Lord. Thank you that because of you, Jesus, there's a oneness, Lord, with you that we can enter into, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. As we hold up the small cup, it represents the blood of Jesus that needed to be spilled for us, that needed to pay the price for us, to cancel our debt, to serve our sentence. We come this morning, Jesus, and what better way to start, Lord, than in 2022 than just by saying thank you, Jesus, that you died for us. Thank you for your blood that has covered our sins, Lord. Thank you that we are forgiven, Lord. We are forgiven our trespasses, Lord. Thank you that as we turn into you, Lord, we can do it joyfully, Lord. And that from now on we can experience your joy and your peace, knowing that death has lost its sting, that we belong to you, Lord. And as Volker said this morning, we are heaven bound. It's not about earth. We're here for a small time, but it's heaven bound, Lord. And we thank you this morning, Jesus, for your blood that was spilled. Lord, and as we end of this morning service, Lord Jesus, I just want to pray and I want to ask that, as we stand here, each one with expectation and a desire for this year, Lord, some of us maybe with challenges ahead of us, Lord, but I pray, Holy Spirit, that you will remind us, that you will remind us to focus on Jesus, that you will remind us daily, Lord, that as we continue daily in our journey with you, we be reminded, Jesus, of the work you did for us, Lord, that the debt was paid, that the sentence was served, and that from now on we have victory in you, that you gave us the victory, that you rose again from the grave, Lord, and you gave us an open door to walk through, to belong to you, to know you intimately, Lord. We just pray for us as a community, as a church in this year, Lord, for that oneness which was talked about, Lord, that we would be one with you in this year in 2022, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I just want to pray this morning, if there's anyone who struggles with health, Lord, and we